Hi there, guys. Welcome to today's Captain's Blog. Fuck.
Harder than it looks, isn't it?
Today's Captain's Blog is made possible by a grant from Tom Mend. Thank you, sir.
Hi there, guys. Welcome to today's Captain's Blog. I'm the Blue Man Group.
Hi there, guys, welcome to today's Captain's Blog. It's 12 o'clock noon on Tuesday, April 4th, 2017, and I'm vindicated! I'm about to autopsy that antique player piano, and it's gonna be glorious, it's gonna be wonderful. So, yeah, I'll try and get you as much blog as I can, but this is production video time, so, you know, you guys are gonna get stuck off over here in the corner, like that. Or something like that, and we'll see how that rolls.
From the live stream, I couldn't actually tell where you were.
I am the boss up. Please don't stand in front of me. I can move.
Yeah.
I can only move in this quadrant.
How's my framing with fucked up?
I am as wide as possible, so you could go around the entire piano.
No, I just wanted to make sure I wasn't, like, blocking.
Well, if you were, I would have told you to move over.
Okay. Hi there, guys. I'm Chris Boden, and welcome to the Geek Group. It is now 12:15 on Tuesday, April 4th, 2017. I make a note of that because I'm about to get a lot of hate mail. I get a lot of hate mail every time I open my mouth, but I especially get a lot of hate mail every time I do something like this. This is an antique player piano. We're going to autopsy. And the first 50 comments that you will see below are people who are like, "You could have saved it! It was a piece of art! It was history! It was special! How could you deface such a..." So I've done an experiment. For the past 24 hours, since yesterday, I posted over a dozen pictures of this, in detail, cleaned it all up because we had to get it ready for pre-production, posted over a dozen pictures and said, "Anybody who wants to buy this, 500 bucks, that's it. Take it home. 500 bucks cash, take it home." Not one person bid. I had a whole bunch of people complain, like, not one person bid. So, I dropped the price all the way down to 200 bucks, hour by hour, over the course of the past day. Not one person bid. So think about that before you comment below with the many ways in which I am a horrible person for destroying history and killing this beautiful instrument. Nobody wanted it. Lots of people wanted to complain about it. Nobody actually wanted to do anything about it. If you see a problem in the world that offends you so much that you feel the need to write pages about it on the internet, take 5 minutes, get off your butt, and actually do something to change it. In the meantime, let's take apart a piano and learn about the inside.
Killing art!
Yes. Ooh, I get to use a big screwdriver right off the bat! Killing art, we're killing childhood memories.
Show that to the close-up.
Life's a lot brighter and happier too because of thoughtful people like you. Really? Oh, wait. Oh, there's a few. We got a birthday card with, I think that's mice. We've got sympathy for flowers and with many thanks. There you go. Oh, there's another one. And we've got a cat. None of these are actually signed or have anything written on the inside. And the Dairy Queen Blizzard of 98 instant win game. A 1991 notice to Medicare patients concerning non-covered surfaces. Band-Aid. It's sterile, though. Mm. So, it's legit. And... instructions to a patient. This piano belonged to a woman named Mary, who is on Medicare and apparently not doing so good. What are we doing? Oh, that! Okay, I see it.
So what's your plan of attack here?
Well, first I just want to get it down to where we can visualize a bunch of it. Oh, I see them. They're covered under gum. Little breast. Yeah, first thing I'm doing is just getting it so that we can see the major part of the piano. Ivory keys. Everything works as far as the basic piano functions. And this is a regular upright piano that happens to have a bunch of extra bits, mainly this setup here. This is a player piano. And it's kind of cool. If you want to get into exploring player pianos, go back in the history. Go like the technological history. Go all the way back to the Jacquard loom, which is where this idea really began. That is binary. It's one of the simplest forms of programming that exists. We have 0, which is just the paper, and then a 1, which is a hole in the paper. This simple concept of holes in things is what gave us IBM solving the problem of the national census, the Jacquard loom, all the way up to the cell phone in your pocket today. This is where it all began. Now, the way this works is, this is a program. In this case, it's for music. So, when there's a hole here, that allows a note to be played. And the way that note is played is there a crank or something? Oh, okay, that'll work. So we have the paper on top.
Pause.
Yeah, I just need to cross.
That's a good idea. Actually ready. You see there's a row of holes here. And as the paper goes by, it gets taken up by the take-up reel on the bottom. As the paper goes by the holes, this allows air to be sucked in through a vacuum system. So this, where air gets sucked in, a note gets played. And there's a transposer down here, which allows you to shift that a little bit left or right. So think of this like adjusting bass to treble. If you shift it this way, it plays everything a little bit lower. If you shift it this way, it plays everything a little bit higher. And that physically moves a set of holes. Beyond that, once this triggers a set of valves inside, and the valves allow the individual mechanisms to be activated through the system. So we've got 3 little blowers here, run off a crank. This is old tech. And this, by the way, is a brand tracker. Manufactured by the Brand Player Accessories Company in New York. Doesn't give me a year, but I really wish it would. But this is a little triple bellow setup working with that. Now these could be being used for pressure or vacuum, and different parts of this work on pressure or vacuum depending on where you are in the system. So, you want me to give you that yet?
Looks like we take this 2 weeks.
I think we can get the whole thing up. We're going to get a ton of hose with it, but let's grab the big screwdriver and give it a shot.
I get to use a giant screwdriver.
There's going to be a ton of stuff connected to this.
That's right, but I have so little.
Yeah, I have a feeling all the. Gloves. You and me. This is like a spring mount. So this is the section that we're taking out is the Pratt Reed pneumatic player action. It's a Model M. Scale is 406. Style is 72. And the serial number is 6340-2. Made by the Pratt River Player Action Company in Deep River, Connecticut. Now, Batman and I are gloving up because a lot of the pipes in this machine are made of lead. Plus, there's kind of creepy, nasty, buggy things living in here. So, you think we can just lift that up? Maybe. Do we want to, or do we want to, like, take this apart? Because this is kind of cool. I kind of want to keep this intact because I have an idea for this.
Right, like we could just didn't just take this whole board.
Somebody wrote in during the 24 hours that we're doing this. Somebody commented on a thing saying we should take this mechanism and make it work. Make this mechanism work with a musical Tesla coil.
That would be cool.
I think that would be neat, and it's worth saving this enough to give that a shot. Let's get the long skinny screwdriver and let's pick out these on the bottom so we keep them out. No, I should keep that there because I think the whole thing I've intact. Now, I'm going to take this box off now, because I don't want to screw it up. Because that's really the heart of what we want to keep. It's just four little show screws. And your side's way easier to get out than mine. It's totally free except for the massive amount of tubes that I'll go in the back. These are all light.
Yep, so.
It's just cut out. What is the worst tubes? Soft money, cut it with any pair of dikes. Here, try with these. Yeah, you got, that's just a tiny section of how many we have to do.
We can cross.
Big red cutters? Yeah, go grab it. Soft lead is not going to hurt. About 88 of those we have to cut.
We should really mic Batman.
Do you want it?
You keep talking to him.
I like talking. He's a nice guy. got a mic right there. Why wouldn't it? It's easy.
Steven. I'm just going to go ahead and stop rolling so we can do that.
Okay, we'll wait.
Nothing like.
Debating an overhead, but that'd be such a bitch to even achieve a shot worth
nightmare.
Using. And I don't want to drag the crane out because it's just going to cast a shadow. But it's just your butts to the camera because there's
Batman,
nowhere else to go.
You know what we're going to do as our next big project? Mm. We're going to overhaul that damn camera crane.
Didn't we buy a camera crane?
Yes.
I gotta leave in about 10 minutes to go do a train.
Alright, I'll just talk to you less while we do this.
Well, we're not rolling, so hold up.
Did you hear the one? Rolling on what?
Here. Go per herb.
Sink!
Go where you need to go. Not you.
You.
Do anything you want,
not you.
We're in. Jerks.
The next 2 hours, I'm going to carry this slime adjustment.
What is it fine adjusting?
It says presto on this end, and there's numbers that go from 130 down to zero, so I'm pretty sure that's tempo. Yeah, it's faded, but you can make that tempo.
Obviously, you're a drummer.
What?
Auto, presto, or anything. You're a magician.
Here. So what do we have here? This is the player bit. Okay. All right, 180. We'll set it up here. So that's totally good for you. So this has a whole bunch of little air bits And I'm guessing they work under vacuum, because if you suck the air out of there, then push that up. And when that pushes up, that shifts one of these up. So that's how it works. It pushes up on those.
They're all rotted.
And this is, yeah, they're all rotted. And this is just a really big manifold.
Yeah.
That's really cool. So this...
That's your air motor. That spins the thing. That's all it does.
So air blows in here, and it moves this.
Yeah. That's how it rotates the music. You have two bellows below the pumps.
I gotta try something. I just gotta know. Let's see if this will work.
When you're done with seeing if it works, re-explain what he just did because he has no mic.
Okay. Yeah, that's not. This is how we get anthrax. In 2017, Chris Boden reintroduced cholera, anthrax, and dysentery to Michigan. Okay, so the way this worked was you've got the air pump down there, and those are just bellows, cranked by feet. This was an air motor here, which turned all the cranks and handled feed, speed, all that jazz. That activated the holes in the thing. The holes in the thing admitted air in. That air controlled the actuation of things in the manifold, which moves these little bags. So under vacuum, these pull up. So it all works off vacuum. So these pull up, and when this pulls up, it moves these here, which is in the middle of the piano mechanism, to move the amp. This must be a mute.
Yeah.
Alright, so let's set this aside. So that's the basics of the player piano. It's actually really simple. There's just a lot of, like a piano, it's a really simple mechanism repeated 88 times. So let's dig into this real quick and cover the inside. Because this is, now we're into just a basic piano, which we've kind of covered a bit in the past, but we have learned through a lot of trial and error that autopsying a piano is a nightmare. Yeah, you do. Look where my hand is.
Oh, yes.
Undo the leather nut. And then you can slide the mechanism over.
Why leather?
That's what they had. I don't know why leather. But a lot of the nuts I've taken off in here are actually made of leather. Which is pretty cool. Oh, God. Allergy nut. You ready? So we have this mechanism, which is, here, let's turn this around so I can see it better. So this gives us the hammers, and these are mutes, or dampers.
Yes, you probably know that as the other ones are vibrating.
Yep. There's no mutes on the upper.
Thank you. about this, just for trying to get the mellows.
Oh, that's good. I don't want to.
Yeah, I don't want to
learn that lesson.
Yeah, I'm not getting this hard. Don't take the heart out, but we're not taking it.
I just kind of want to leave it. It'll be easier for me to move it so I can.
All right.
Get the hell out of here.
Yeah, I think we take those out and just pop right out, and
we can see the bellows.
Yep.
All good.
Yep.
Start rolling again.
Yep.
Rolling on white.
Clap, please.
Sing.
Thank you.
Did suspend that hole for 100 years. Now you thinking we want to take this out or lay it down and go in the front?
Huh?
Okay, we're going the top.
Oh hey.
I need that to at least get the
wall.
That's it. This thing I can at least grab. Oh yeah. This one's a really long, giant screwdriver. I'm just gonna have to tease this out. Make a screw that big. You should cut the slot rather. Yeah, this I'm maybe. That's too much. It's better than the other one. That's fine. Let's never do that anymore. Get out of the rear neck.
That ain't happening. Batman.
Yeah.
One Catholic kid to another, what's that?
It's our Christopher.
It's a Saint somebody.
Well, it's got the Marian
yeah.
on the back. Can't read that. I'll clean it up and get the Latin off.
Alright, we'll figure it out. Run that through the ultrasonic parts, please. Alright, I got all my screws out over here. Thing.
That's just not interesting.
Got it. I got a screw buried up here. Ah, it screws me up. No, I don't think that's an indexing pin for the big mechanism.
That one looks like it's holding it. Maybe not better.
Stop and get some Benadryl.
No, this lady had like 50 cats, or the cat slept on the piano, or I've got anthrax.
Figure you right at both.
Got cat anthrax.
Yeah.
These usually open right up like this. This whole panel should just pop right up. Here.
Batman.
Yeah, I'm bored.
Thankfully, we have tool
for when it gets bored. Mr. Bellatini.
There's no way to recreate that.
Batman?
Yep.
I'm bored.
Oh.
Thankfully,
Batman got us properly prepared for this.
I'm just going to remove this piece.
All right.
Gently.
Delicate.
Pause. I'm getting the fuck out of the way.
Yeah, I'm getting him up. You good?
As good as I can get.
That's loose. You know this is like three sizes too big for me, this particular subject.
It's my grip.
Oh. Now what's holding it?
Probably a support.
Let's look. That's one way to do it.
Something I didn't think. The bellows work in vacuum. They're opening. I think the whole thing works on vacuum. Instead of having a pressure component, the vacuum component?
Yeah, I
agree. Yeah, don't let.
Wow. We're going to real screwdrivers. Because the screws are really tight.
I'm surprised if they're not the iron. Alright. Now see if that moves.
Disconnected over here. I'd like to see it back.
on your side, go up on mine on this. Yeah, I'm trying to find it. Hold it. I see a couple. And they're the little leather nuts, so I'll get them off. Here. Got it! Ha ha! Oh, there's still one over here. If you hold your position, I can get that out. It smells like old people. Muscle it up, you gotta take out the little leather nut. Turns out leather nuts are really good. Hey, put your pants on. Camera behind you. You're scaring the kids. Other way you're typing. That's out. This one will be out. Something just occurred to me. If you're playing this and you're using the bellows system, they totally occlude the actual pedals for playing the piano. So you can't do both at the same time.
That's a little sweet.
That's mildly terrifying. Still generates a vacuum. Well, there's two openings on this side too, but it's like, it's moving air. Now, what is that over there? It's a little box. Oh, okay. So that's actuated by the switch, the linkage, doesn't it? Now down to the harp. We're staying. I'm not taking one of those apart again. We shot a video a long time ago of taking a piano apart. And we got down to this part.
we didn't know when to stop. We're like, we're gonna take the whole thing apart. I ain't ever doing that again. But this is the actual harp. This is a big piece of cast iron. This isn't bronze. This is a big piece of cast iron that is spray-painted bronze. But this is all of the things that actually make the sound are right there. So we have now explored all the way into a player piano. How do you feel?
It's awesome.
It went a lot quicker and easier than I thought it would.
Yep.
I think it's because we have prior experience with the piano, because that video went so well. So there you have it, an autopsy of a player piano. It all runs on vacuum. It starts right here with a pair of really big bellows. You guys have fun. I'm Chris Boden.
I'm Batman. Hopefully he picked it up.
They can totally hear you.
Yeah.
Talk to my chest!
That's what I was trying to do.
Okay.
Do that again.
So there you have it, guys. An autopsy of a player piano. Until next time, I'm Chris Boden.
And I'm Batman.
And as always, we'll see you next time. Fucking suck. So, what are you doing? So there you have it. An autopsy of a player piano.
Wait for it to stop.
It's dramatic.
It's also one hell of a jump cut that I can't cover.
So I think that just about covers it.
Should be.
Like, we got all the way down to the bellows. We're like, we're down to the harp, and I'm not doing that again. So that's it. Thank you guys for watching. I'm Chris Boden.
And I'm Batman.
And as always, we'll see you next time.
Stop rolling.
Now I need to go and put my head back in the computer for like 20 minutes. Oh my Christ.
That's perfect, because like now they should just
I can't miss it.
So time is 15:06. Lefty, tell the blog what you told me.
The bores are too big to go any further, and they are scored really bad on it. And the machine shop said four of the cylinders had collapsed.
Okay, so we're talking about the $350 engine I bought for the big boat.
Correct.
Okay, so the block is fucked, the heads are fucked.
Yep.
The engine is fucked.
Correct.
Okay. I want your opinion on something.
Okay.
Now I'm going to get your opinion, I'm going to get the blog's opinion, because I don't want to do this lightly.
Right.
What do you say of rolling the big boat in, doing the exact thing we did to the Bayliner, and doing the exact same plan? Strip it, shit can the boat.
I'd say we haven't really done anything to it, so I mean...
No, I got a few days of cleaning it and that, and I did the windows, but that's a couple $100 in plastic. Right. But we strip it down to nothing, we shit can the hull, that leaves us with two empty trailers, both of which, well, one's already completely overhauled.
Right.
But we overhaul that trailer, like the big trailer, sell it, overhaul that trailer, and either sell it or use it, and put that boat on the other trailer.
That might be a good idea.
Yeah, I want to keep that one for now. Yeah.
Size, whereas that's a little...
Your other option is, there is a lot of 350s out there. It's just finding a good one.
I just paid $350 for one,
for
and
a
got
motor that's
fucked by a dude on eBay. Or Craigslist dude.
Like $800 or $1,000 to buy.
And... we can buy that boat for $5,000.
Yeah. Right, because it's a Bayliner.
Yeah, it's a shitty Bayliner boat.
Walmart Express.
Yeah. That's and
if we get another Bayliner, we're going to call it the Walmart Express.
God. But I'm just like, fuck this boat. We can make a couple bucks on the trailer before I put any more into that damn thing.
That's kind of, and we get the outdrive looked good on it. We might be able to
We'll get some parts off it.
Right.
Yeah.
You want to gut it?
I'd say the only other real thing to gut on it would be the rest of the bell housing for the outdrive and maybe the rails, but all the rails are kind of jank on it anyway.
I'd take the horns
and you will have a crankshaft too that you can sell. You said the crank
the shifter,
is the only thing that's good in there.
And what can I get for that?
It's a 350 crankshaft for a boat. I think you could get a couple hundred.
Go ahead and sell it.
Let's pull this.
What do you think I should do? I want your insight on this. Comment and tell me what you think I should do.
So we're going your way?
Yeah, I got it. There's no way we're getting this muffler.
Oh, all right.
I mean, can you tilt it inward? Inward. Yeah. No, I'm going to have to cut it.
All right.
Yeah.
Not going to be under there while you're cutting it.
you could probably sell like the water system and all that, like, because all the tanks were good.
Yeah, we'll.
You have
we'll...
two of everything. You can sell all the parts.
Okay.
And we know the toilets cost a metric fuck ton.
Yeah, the toilets are expensive. I cleaned that one. It's beautiful. All right, we'll be back.
All right, guys, time is 16:01 hours, and I'm taking off my watch because I've played this game before. And we're going to do carpet and a boat. We just screwed this down. I'm rolling time lapse, so you'll get to see this whole thing. But we just screwed down the floor piece over the fuel tank, which is awesome. I never got to use the Craig jig before, but that thing is the shit. And I'm just waiting on a putty knife to get here, which is on its way in mere moments. And we're going to carpet a boat. This will be Batman's boat. And we have some just ugly-ass basic blue carpeting. Nothing special, just cheap shit. And yeah, so we're going to carpet a boat. It'll be fun. Okay, so we got our putty knife. Time is 16:04. And this is like cream thin, low viscosity glue. I might need a fucking ladle. Sure, there's a better way to do this. Let's do this area heavy and see what I get out of that.
Oh, I see.
Set that over there. Trowel it out. Eventually, but I need a much more efficient delivery method. So, can't have too much. It's just glue. This may very well just be a gallon of Elmer's glue. I wonder if I can just... probably a bit much.
It'll spread.
I like to think so. Shit's gonna spread like herpes. It's gonna be fine. It's just glue. Oh my god. Oh yeah. Look at that. That's beautiful.
Release your inner warrior.
Telling yourself that. It's just. Thank you.
released the shrew. You know what I'm making here? Structural carpet. Trowel work like this, I am eminently qualified to do highly intricate, delicate work, like parking lots.
Oh, it's so awesome.
See, I got to skip this. You don't know. Okay, take the bucket. Do not hold the bucket over the bone. Hold the bucket over the... Yeah. I am on the carpet. There we go. Okay. It's a Catholic glue. It's got it everywhere but. Take that. Thank you.
All right. Now.
Set stuff down, can use a hand. We gotta smush this out flat. There is a knife. No, not that knife. Oh. It's a gray knife. Here you go. Batman, where'd a gray knife go?
What?
Gray knife. Gonna need that about now.
It was sitting on the little seat.
This one? Yep. No. Where's it at, Batman?
It was on the seat. That's where I left it.
I got every knife but that one.
Then I don't know where you put it.
What seat?
On the boat seat, the inside seat. I sat down with the
screwdriver.
Like over
here?
Oh, there. I'm going to take a minute to fix that.
Hey, what's this material?
Right there under the screws.
It was hidden.
God damn it. The world.
I don't have to get up there,
do I? No, you don't have to get up here. That'd be bad.
You make that look really hard.
Yes. I don't make it look hard. It really is. It's really not that hard. I'm just that fucking uncoordinated.
Didn't put a mark there with a Sharpie, did you?
No, I did not mark the finished layer of carpet with my Sharpie so that I would know there's a hole there. Because I'm dumb, but I'm not that fucking just... Oh my god. All right, hold that corner.
pull a little bit.
Yeah.
Okay. Hold this down.
Okay, it's gonna be fine. Everything's gonna be fine.
Everything's gonna be fine. It's gonna be okay.
Everything is going according to plan.
Everything is totally fine. The carpet, the glue is so thick it's seeping up in spots.
Through the carpet. That's okay.
Okay. All right, now. Now we're going to start the trimming. As we get the carpet smoothed the fuck out. Okay. Cut that down. Start there.
Here. Oh, that cuts a lot better than I thought it would.
It's really shitty cheap carpet.
Oh. Huh.
It's not that it cuts a lot better, it's that it cuts so easily. We're just roughing it in at this stage. I have a lot of heavy, flat things. Hey, Lefty, you're not doing anything. Come here. I need heavy, flat things. Bricks are awesome. Bricks are great.
Two right by your feet.
I need bricks. Bricks are lovely.
There's two right under this guy.
I need heavy, flat things.
We need more than two?
Yeah. Come on. Scrap bits of 2x4.
Just start grabbing computers from downstairs.
Actually, that's not a bad
idea. That's not a bad idea.
I feel like that can't be right.
What about
why not?
Batteries?
I don't know.
Batteries? No, not boat batteries. Not full-size batteries. No, but small batteries are good. No, I can't because of the glue.
Yeah, Paul might kill you.
We need flat, heavy things that won't be fucked up by a little bit of glue. I could use a stapler too.
Is the cinder block too heavy?
No!
Paving stone?
Paving stone's good.
Whatever.
There, that'll set edge. Back right here. Alright.
4x4 is too light?
Huh? 4x4s are kind of light, but bring them. Can't hurt. Gives me a flat spot.
You can put them around the hole.
You got exhaust from the boat over there.
Got any more rotors?
There should be some in that thing. Lighting.
We've got railroad.
No, I can't use track.
I know.
Thank you.
She's got another brake rotor.
And a bottle of Rain-X.
Darn straight, it's heavy.
Get a box of screws. Definitely good. There's a bottle of Rain-X back there. Back here.
It's probably still less time.
Now at least I can see where the fucking hole is. You got our brake rotor,
which I'm going to put.
Alright.
Those have weight to them.
What, those? Oh, yellows are perfect. Your blue won't stick to them. 2HMW, poor man's Teflon.
Is that enough?
Oh, yeah. Half of the boat carpeted.
Yay.
It's progress.
What else has to be carpeted?
The other half of the boat.
I'm well on my way.
But this half's a little trickier than the other half.
Mmm, smell that glue. Chris is high.
I like it. For now, though, we'll stop there. Because I want to give this some time to, like, attach. Put the lid on the glue for now.
Is this the same program?
And we'll clean off the tools.
We'll
be back. Time is 16:34 hours. Joey the gnome is carving out the boat.
Yeah.
What? What?
Nothing.
Doesn't bother me.
So... tell them what you found.
More crappy boat.
You want to grab a piece of that and show them how soft it is?
Yes.
What did we find?
Look at this. It's just,
it's rotted, yeah.
It's not so much rotted as
it's mud. It's like old leaves. Yeah, it doesn't surprise me.
The boat is compost. It's that bad. The boat is compost. There's legit soil forming down here. I got a boat made out of wood chips.
Fuck! I think I used to make boats out of.
Huh?
They always used to make boats out of wood chips. They were just all glued together.
Wood chips.
It's like a great place to plant a garden.
All right. I'm going to dry my feet off, and we'll do the next round of goop. Be back. Let's do the front half. So we've got enough. We're good. All I got to do is lay it down, and then spread it side to side. It's gonna be fine. Everything's gonna be fine.
You know it worries me when you say that.
Everything's fine. It's gonna be okay. Nothing to get upset about. Alright, give me the tool.
Well, it's already been up here, so the
I will never surrender! So we went a little excessive on the glue on the back now.
Chris, you don't really have a choice.
Fuck you! I'm not giving up!
Well, no, but you don't actually have a choice. If you shave your head, you don't have anything going for you at that point. We all see what you look like, and you look what you look like.
Yeah, I look like a dildo with ears.
You do a hair implant.
No, I'm not. I ain't ever going to do plugs, drugs, or rugs. It ain't happening. Once it goes past my ears, then I'll shave it. Till that point, I ain't giving up.
It's not that bad, though.
I like how it feels. I just don't like how it looks. It feels great. I love my head shavers. All right, so I got to be a little bit more conservative. the glue. And now that I know that I've got a really long working time on this, I don't have to work so fast. I'm used to glue where you gotta hustle. This is lazy glue. I don't know what that is, but I think this is a big bucket of elements.
Mod Podge is crafting glue.
Oh, okay.
This one's almost through. I don't know if we just hit a bad spot on that last one or what.
I think it was fighting the weld.
It looks like we cut it almost the exact same spot on both.
Hodgepodge?
Mod Podge.
What the fuck is Mod Podge?
It's that. It's
it's crafting glue.
Scrapping? Oh, okay.
It's like art stuff.
Yeah. It's called it Elmer's. It has a cow on it.
Yeah.
The cow's name's Elsie.
You can buy it in a big bucket, and it's called Mod Podge, and you can do it. It's like a, you use it for like a finisher. But you can also do shit with it.
Next time I do this, glue ladle.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'm getting it back.
Never hold it up.
That just lets it all run over a little bit.
Sorry.
Idea, and we should have filled this, but I'm gonna do it anyway.
Learn for next time, right?
No, this is lessons I already knew. I just don't give a shit because this is crappy boat carpet, crappy boat. Carpet really don't matter, and we don't really care. This boat's just shits and giggles. I've done this for real. This is just, we need carpet in the boat.
Hmm.
Fine. Start at the ass, aft, and trim it up. And we'll be set. Thank you. Or you could watch this part. This is kind of cool. This is where it all like comes into focus and actually looks as good as it's ever going to look. Okay. Notice I didn't say it looks good. It's just going to look as good as it's ever going to look.
Well, I'm
going
to go ahead and at least close the glue. So.
Oh yeah, you can close the glue.
Bad.
Chris Boden, do you suffer from having a micropenis? Well, then there's nothing that can really quite announce that fact to the world, like the F-250 Super Duty. Go get yourself a big fucking pickup truck. Cut the exhaust off and blast through the west side. And you can announce to all your friends that you've got a thimble dick. We're here to help. F-250 Super Duty. So, we got carpet in the boat. It came out surprisingly good. It needs a little trimming. It's not quite done yet, but I'm going to let it dry before I do the tuck up front. But it looks like shit, but it looks better than it did. And the floor is solid. It's Batman's boat, so he can stomp around in there, and I want it to be rigorously constructed. Huh?
Just like, that's your boat? It's like, apparently, you can go out and sell it. It's like a mic.
My plan is long term, that's your boat. So, what are you working on?
I'm just finding out where they take boats.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's a good idea. If anybody out there wants to buy the legit ivory keys for that, let me know. Send me a message on Facebook or something. I'll be back.
Today's Captain's Blog is made possible by a grant from Tom Mend. Thank you, sir.